The weight of the world tips us over. The winds of world events spin us round. There's so much going on in the news, it's a challenge to keep track of it all. Last Monday, there was an immigration rights march hosted by Somos. This Wednesday, at 10 o'clock, the high school students are walking out for 17 minutes in honor of the students who were killed. 2 weeks from now, there is a march from the State House to the plaza starting at noon, the March for Our Lives. It's organized by the same folks who organized the Women's March. There is pressure and turbulence in our culture. There's a sense that we are at a tipping point. The energy unleashed a year ago has ebbed and flowed, but it continues to build to the point where it feels like we are poised right on the edge of a new reality, right on the edge. And I have to believe that our small actions can make a difference between whether we tip over into a reality that reflects our fondest dreams, or if we trip into a reality that is the stuff of our nightmares. The theme this month is balance. The ability to stay vertical. The ability to land on our feet and to move easily in any direction depending on the demands of the world around us. The ability to reclaim our equanimity, to maintain our homeostasis. As you saw earlier, when I was talking with the kids, we do not come into this world knowing how to do that. Balance is a learned skill. We begin by learning to sit and hold our heads up, and then to stand. And if we're lucky, if we're among the fortunate, we learn to walk and to run and to ride a bike, and through it all, at every step of the game, we all fall down, right? And then we get up again, and we start over. After we figured out how to do that kinesthetically, and virtually all of us have that embodied experience of balancing, falling, and trying again. After we figure out how to do that kinesthetically, we turn our balancing abilities to other things. We learn to balance our budget, to balance our checkbook, to balance our diet, to balance our weekends and our work days. And as we're learning these things, we also fall from time to time. We overdraw the checking account. We gain or lose weight that we hadn't intended. We fail the exam because we haven't sorted out how you balance study time and socializing. Our relationship might crash and burn because we haven't figured out how to balance our needs and the needs of our loved one. In every part of our lives, it takes conscious effort to learn how to balance. But here's the interesting thing. After we figure it out, we forget, right? You internalize it. When you're walking across the room, you just walk. You don't carefully place your feet. Well, maybe some of you do, because we take it for granted until something changes. We change. Our vision or hearing are less. Our response time slows. Or the world changes. If we haven't been paying attention to the changing of the world, to the rise of new technologies which have us communicating in different ways, to the shifting political alliances that are out there, to our differing understandings about how economics should be deployed in our cultures to climate change. To climate change. We haven't been paying attention to either what's going on in ourselves, our own wholeness, or to what's going on in the world around us as it shifts, then we may find ourselves disoriented. We may find ourselves off balance. We might fall. Now, it's probably 18 months ago now, but I had a fall in our parking lot out here. It was nighttime. It was about at the change of the year because the streetlight in the parking lot wasn't on, and that's on a timer that we have to change, and so it hadn't been changed yet. And I was talking to the person who was sitting in the car and putting something in the trunk, and I stepped in exactly the wrong way on a pebble about this big. And I didn't see it coming. My feet went out from under me, and I was down on the ground before I knew it. Now, since I didn't see it coming, I didn't tense, I didn't try to grab anything, I just went down. I ended up with a skinned knee and a bruised ego and no lasting damage. And the next morning, we set the timer on the light. But the experience, as I was thinking about the sermon, the experience left me thinking about what is it that we adults do when we lose our balance? We respond really differently than children do. What do? Afraid of injury or insult, we tense when we think we're going to fall. We grab for the nearest object or the nearest familiar idea, and we hang on for dear life. Or we throw out our arms and our backsides to try and make ourselves bigger and keep our balance that way. I've never met a single adult who giggled and shouted, "Kaboom!" when she went down, or who grinned and reached up and said, "Again," after she landed. When we were little kids, falling was a game. It was London Bridge and Ring a Ring a Rosies. When we were a little bit bigger, we were willing to fall even further. Nathaniel and I were trading stories, and we both remember swinging on the end of a long rope and letting go just at the point, the farthest point of the arc, and dropping into a lake or into a pile of hay in the hayloft. There was no fear in that fall. There was excitement. There was trust. There was a sense of adventure. When Isaac and Zoe were tiny, and of course, having twins learn to walk or do anything else, you kind of have to double think because there aren't enough hands to go around to catch everybody. So we padded with those rubber mats the entire floor of the house. We removed every piece of furniture that had sharp corners, and we made sure that there were kid-height handholds when they were cruising so they could move from one piece of furniture to the next. And then when they were brave enough to move into the center of the room to let go of whatever it was, what did we do? You know this if you've helped kids who are learning to walk. One of you does this behind them, and the other one does this out in front. And when they make it, what do? You cheer, right? It's a wonderful big deal. We have to learn to walk. We have to learn to trust that when we fall, we're going to be okay. Because when we don't have that trust, we're afraid to take the next risky step. So to stay balanced in a changing world, to risk moving in such a way we can help the world tip in the way we want it to go, those of us who are grown-ups are going to have to rethink and relearn what it means to fall. Now, I know what I would need to feel safe falling. It may or may not be true for you, but I'm going to offer it as a starting point for thinking about this. When I was swinging on the end of the rope, one of the things that made me feel safe was that I was strong enough to hold on until I chose to let go. Okay? So having the strength to be able to choose is one of the things I need when I'm taking a risk. The other thing that made it safe, made falling or dropping safe, was that I was confident of a safe landing. You know, that's when we clench with fear in a fall, it's because we're afraid we're not going to land safe. We didn't choose to fall, and we weren't confident that we would be safe when we landed. So whether I'm going to be safe when I land because I'm going to land on my feet, or whether I'm going to be safe when I land because someone loves me enough to have padded the entire floor of the house, or whether I'm going to be safe because someone is going to catch me, or because magically I've grown wings or a parachute, doesn't matter. You gotta feel safe and confident that after you take the risk and you let go, you're gonna be safe when you land. And the only way you are gonna know that is if you do it over and over and over again. Our culture is inviting us right now to swing to the end of the rope and drop. Immigration, women's rights, gun violence, climate change, voters' rights, these are the hot topics that were in the news this past week, and there will be just as many next week. And we're called to pivot somehow between one and the other and to decide on any given issue. Is this one where I'm going to keep hanging on to the rope and swinging? Or is this one where I'm going to let go and put my energy into the struggle to tip the balance? At a moment's notice, you or I or all of us together may be called to lend our votes, our voices, or our bodies to the swelling wave tipping events in the direction of a healthier, more sustainable, more just and compassionate world. And I have to tell you, clinging to what we know, tensing our muscles, flailing for our familiar sense of where the center is, that's not going to help in the time where we live. We need to be ready to make whichever commitment speaks to our hearts. We need to be ready to let go of the rope and drop wholeheartedly, the same way we used to jump into our parents' arms as children when they stood in the pool and they said, "Come on in." We have to be willing to fall the way we fall into a lover's arms, the way we fall in love with our children after they're born, the way we fall in love with the New Mexico landscape and the New Mexico sky. To take the risks, to engage the world, we need to be strong. We need to be able to choose. We need to trust in a safe landing. We need to practice. Do you know what makes Unitarian Universalist communities strong in the midst of turmoil? It's that we give time and attention every single week to how we live together from our shared values. Time and attention every single week given to connecting with one another. Do you know what helps us take risks and then land safely? It's practice here in this safe community, putting our values in action with one another. Practice covenanting with and catching one another. To grow strong, We need to root ourselves in love and justice. We need to study together the issues and the possible solutions. We need to fill ourselves up with inspiration and beautiful music. We need to reach out and join hands, knowing that we are strong, knowing that we can catch one another if we fall. Then we can throw our voices, our votes, our whole selves out into the world to tip the balance towards a better tomorrow. May it be so.